Now, let's talk about cars, because Jeep is unveiling its first all-electric SUV in the U.S., the Jeep Wagoneer S. It will retail for about $72,000, and it will hit the market this fall. Joining us now for more, I'm thrilled to say we have Antonio Filosa. He is the CEO of the Jeep brand. Let's talk about that price tag. $72,000, that's relatively high compared to some of your competitors. Talk us through the pricing strategy there.
Yeah. So the value that we put in this car is absolutely outstanding. This is the fastest Jeep ever. It goes from 0 to 60 in less than 3.4 seconds. It's got a range of 300 miles plus. It's got a torque of 617 pound-feet. Talking of technology, 45 inches of usable screens inside. An unbelievable selection of very precious material and a sense of craftsmanship in the car. All that with an unbelievable and unbelievably aerodynamic design. So we believe that all the value that is in there, the price is pretty competitive. And by the way, it's exactly in the middle of the segment, mid-size SUV segment. The pre-order are open today. Four clicks, go to from Jeep.com, Jeep.com, four clicks to get your car. You choose your color, your interiors, your dealer, and you buy it. So please do that.
So there you go. Point taken that when it comes to the price tag, of course, we're talking about speed and we're talking about features. But even still, I'm curious to hear a little bit more about Jeep's pricing strategy overall, because the narrative out there is that prices are too high. Jeep is losing share in the U.S. and that inventory at dealerships is piling up. So how do you adjust at this point? Do you cut prices? Do you cut production? What's next?
So we will have a second half with many new launches and product action. And each one of those occasions, we will work on product competitiveness. So we will give to our dealer more competitiveness to sell more Jeeps and also other Stellantis cars. So we believe that second half will be the perfect timing to adjust inventory while we work on technology, on innovation, and product competitiveness through price mostly and through incentive as well.
So through price, through incentive, it sounds like production levels not necessarily going to change there.
Production, I believe, can stay at the level it is. Obviously, we will monitor week by week and month by month to see if some fine-tuning is needed. But the point is to heat up the sales. And to heat up the sales, we'll launch product action associated to price competitiveness actions.
All right, so addressing that through demand, trying to boost demand rather than supply. Really appreciate the color there. I do want to talk about something that the CEO of Stellantis said, of course, Stellantis being your parent company, saying that the company plans to roll out a $25,000 EV in the U.S., quote, very soon. How soon is very soon?
Well, he said very soon, so I confirmed that I cannot say how soon. In the next 1 year, Jeep only has three important launches on the same platform. So today you saw Jeep Wagoneer S. Please pre-order online, four clicks to have your Jeep Wagoneer S. Then you will have another one, which is Jeep Recon in 3 months. And then you will have another one, I cannot say the name, but it's going to compete in the mainstream mid SUV segment. So we have three Jeep cars on the same platform, built in North America, designed by American engineers, that will be available to the market in less than 12 months. In the core of the market, which is the mid SUV segment, that is a segment of 4.2 million units sold per year. It's the largest segment in the planet. We come from zero cars in that segment. Jeep will be with three in less than 1 year.
All right, so it's four clicks, not five, not three, to pre-order that Jeep there. But I understand that you won't tell me the name or specifics on the timing of when we could see that $25,000 EV, but I have to try to make some news here. So can you give us any color on where it will actually be built, what platform that you plan to use?
Those three cars that I mentioned, they will be built in Toluca, Mexico, on Stella Large platform, which is the platform that is that plan. The 25,000 BV Jeep will be built later, so after this year. And we are still identifying the plant. The platform is what we call Stella Small or Smart Car, which is a very competitive platform. That's why we are able to build such a big value, Jeep branded, into 25,000 BEV. We will have also other options. Our strategy is freedom of choice. That means that out of the 7 powertrain system available today in the market, we will offer to the market 6 in our range. So our customer can buy BEVs if they want, but can buy HEV, plug-in hybrid, mild hybrid, IC, extended range that we are launching next year. So we are full of novelties in the next 12 months and later.
All right, so definitely a lot to keep an eye on there. When it comes to Jeep and your future plans, I am curious about what your ambition is when it comes to where you are geographically. I was talking to our resident car guy, Matt Miller, this morning, and he made the point that there aren't really many Jeep dealers in Europe, for example. If you want to buy a car there, you have to do it through an importer. How global do you really want to be when it comes specifically to Jeep?
Oh, we are the most global brand of Stellantis. Last year we sold 1 million units, being 70% in North America, but there is a large part, 15% in South America, 15% in Europe and the rest of the world. So our global stance as Jeep give us the opportunity to assess of global scales. And global scales and volumes obviously means to a brand of cars the possibility to create synergy and to have access to higher resource and invest in more innovation, for instance, in powertrain. So to be global is very important for Jeep. Obviously, we are deep into American roots. We are the most patriotic brand overall. And this is recognized by Americans that every year be voting about that. There is a survey that states that Jeep is the most patriotic brand overall. So we come in this survey before Disney, for instance, before McDonald's, for instance. So we are very, very, very recognized as American, but we are global. And this global aspect of our business give us access to global scales, which is important when it comes to product development.
So committed to being global, I want to talk about your commitment to battery electric vehicles, full EVs versus hybrids, for example, which a lot of your competitors are pivoting more heavily to. How are you thinking about that as you look to the future? Are you going to really double down on full EVs here, or is maybe the future looking a little bit more hybrid?
No, we are the possibility to offer to the market absolutely everything. So our strategy, freedom of choice, give us the flexibility to develop many, many, many innovations and technologies for the same market. So for instance, now we are in a moment where the pace of growth of battery electric vehicle is there, but not at the level that we thought. We will launch very soon extended range, which is a REEV, so a kind of hybrid technology for Grand Wagoneer and Wagoneer. This is next year. We will launch after the big success of Wrangler 4xe, which is a PHEV, and Grand Cherokee 4xe, which is a PHEV, a Gladiator, Jeep Gladiator, the pickup PHEV as well. And we will launch other in the rest of the world, such as mild hybrid and hybrid. So to Jeep, the point is, how much time do we need to offer on very versatile platform the powertrain that in that moment the market is willing. And our engineering give us the possibility to switch in six months on the same platform for one powertrain to another.
And Antonio, I only have about 30 seconds left with you, but before I let you go, tell me about the future of gas-powered Jeeps. Are you still going to keep producing them or scale back production?
No, we are producing them, for sure. For sure. It's one of our powertrain that we want to offer, yes.
All right. So still committed there to that gas-powered vehicle. Really appreciate your time, Antonio. Know it's a busy day for you. That, of course, is Antonio Filosa. He is the CEO of Jeep.